Hello, my dear friends. Today you are going to listen to a story about a boy. After that, do the test. This is our new classmate. His name is Elliot. He lives in Orange Street. His house is old, but nice. His family is not very big. Mommy, daddy, and a baby sister. His mother works at school. She is a teacher. His father works on a farm. Elliot has a special hobby. He likes magic. Elliot likes books too. Every Saturday his family goes on a picnic to the park, but yesterday they didn't. It was rainy and they had a home party. They cooked a lot of food and had fun. Elliot and his family will go on a picnic next Saturday. Now it's time for you to do the test. Good luck! Hello, my dear friends. In this video, you are going to listen to the story. After that, do the test. Today, we shall speak about the seasons. There are four seasons in a year: spring, summer, autumn, and winter. What's your favorite season, Tom?
My favorite season is autumn. It's a beautiful season. The leaves in the trees are red, yellow, brown, and green. It is warm in September. I can go for a walk. On the 1st of September, I'm glad to see my friends at school after the long summer holidays. In autumn, there are a lot of vegetables and fruit. I like sweet pears. I don't like autumn. It's a dull season. I don't like when it rains. In October, it is cold and it often rains, and we can't go for a walk. I like summer. Summer is a bright season. The trees are green. It's hot and I can swim in the river. I can play outdoors all day long, and I don't go to school. And my favorite season is winter. Winter is beautiful. The trees are white with snow. There is a lot of snow in the streets and in the parks. My friends and I can play snowballs and hockey, but most of all, I like to ski.
Thank you, David. How about you, Susan? What's your favorite season?
I don't like winter. It's so cold in winter. It often snows. The sky is gray. The days are short and the nights are long. I like spring. The sun often shines. The sky is blue. Birds sing songs. In May, the trees and grass are bright green. There are many beautiful flowers in May.
Well, children, I think all seasons are good and beautiful. Everything is good in its season. Do the test. Good luck!
I want to talk about my daily routine today. My alarm goes off every morning at 6:20 on weekdays. I always wake up around 10 minutes after that, which would be 6:30. I go to the bathroom first, and after drinking a glass of water, I start making breakfast. My breakfast is usually a salad, boiled egg, and one slice of bread. When it's 7, I go wake up my child, who's in elementary. While eating breakfast, I watch the news with my child or have a conversation. My child often talks about school when we talk while eating. Around 7:40, my child and husband leave the house together. I take care of the dishes, brush my teeth, and get my hair ready. Of course, I can't forget to apply my makeup. I leave the house around 8:30 and go to work with my car. At 9, I drink coffee while checking my emails. At noon, I eat lunch at the company cafeteria. I resume work at 1. At 5 in the afternoon, I leave my workplace and go to the grocery store before going home. When I'm home, I quickly make dinner and eat with all of my family around 7. If I get home late, we order something to our house, like pizza. After dinner, I help with my child's homework. After my child gets to sleep at 9, it's my free time. I watch TV with my husband, talk, or read at my pace until 11. I shower at 11, and after lightly doing stretches, I go to sleep. On Saturdays, I wake up around 7 in the morning, and after breakfast, we all clean the rooms or do the laundry. On Saturday afternoons, I drop off my child at their extracurricular lessons, and I go to the gym.
Listen to a student talking to the receptionist of a language school.
Are you a new student?
Yes, I am.
I need to ask you some questions.
Okay.
What's your first name?
Alisa.
Alisa? How do you spell that?
A-L-I-S-A.
Thanks. And what's your surname, Alisa?
Bernard. That's B-E-R-N-A-R-D.
Fine. How old are you?
I'm 22.
Where are you from?
I'm from France, from Paris, the capital city.
What's your address in the U.S.?
14 Ramsey Street, Brooklyn.
And your zip code?
Oh, it's 11-222.
What's your phone number?
My cell phone?
Yes, please.
It's 718-555-8545.
718-555-8545.
I always eat a good amount of breakfast. For example, my breakfast this morning was a salad, eggs, sausages, bread, and a tomato soup. I love to wake up early in the morning and make a delicious breakfast. Eating breakfast while feeling the sunshine is the best. This has been something I've always done since childhood. There were 4 kids in my family, and all of them loved sports. Everyone had a huge appetite from the morning. Because of that, my mom always woke up early and made a hearty breakfast. Thanks to that, my mind and body worked very well from the morning. A while ago, when my friend slept over at my house, she was very surprised after seeing the breakfast I had prepared. My friend is the type who can't eat a lot in the mornings, so apparently, she always only has a cup of coffee. According to my friend, if she eats a lot in the morning, she feels unpleasant. In my case, I always lessen my lunch. If I eat a lot for lunch, I get sleepy in the afternoons, making my work efficiency slow down. My friend and I are complete opposites. Because she doesn't eat much for breakfast, she gets very hungry around 11. That's why she apparently eats a lot for lunch. It seems like everyone has different rhythms for their body. I saw on the TV a while ago, but there are also people who only eat once per day. Instead of having breakfast and lunch, they apparently eat around 2,500 kilocalories for their dinner. I'm worried about their health if they eat like that, but the people who do that look very healthy themselves. They exercise a lot daily, so apparently they don't gain weight even if they eat a lot at night. I can never copy them. One of my friends only eats a salad for dinner. That friend also goes to the gym and is very skinny. I copied her once and only ate salad for dinner. However, I gave up after 2 days. If I don't eat meat or fish for the main dish of dinner, I can't sleep in the night because of hunger. In the end, I woke up at midnight and ate 1 slice of bread with 1 glass of milk. And then I was finally able to sleep peacefully. Depending on the country, there also may be times when you eat 5 meals in a day. There are doctors who say that eating 4 to 5 light meals is more healthy for the body. However, eating 3 meals a day is the best for my body.
Are you a morning person or a night owl?
Morning.
Coffee person or tea guy?
Coffee in the morning, tea in the afternoon.
What's the first thing you do when you wake up every morning?
Wear my running shoes.
What's on your work desk right now?
Too many computers to count.
What's on your smartphone home screen?
The number one icon, Wunderlist.
Comic Sans, good or bad font?
A good font.
Favorite workday time waster?
Cortana jokes.
Favorite personal possession?
Oh, a cricket bat signed by Sachin Tendulkar.
Would you rather go to a Clippers game with Steve Ballmer or play bridge with Bill Gates?
I think I'll play, I'll go to a Clippers game with Steve Ballmer.
How do you run a meeting?
Listen more. Talk less, and be decisive when the time comes.
The one trait that I look for in new hires is?
Do they create clarity? Do they create energy?
If you could explain cricket rules to someone in the U.S., what's the one thing you would tell them?
It's impossible.
Who's been the greatest influence on you?
My parents. My dad is an economist, leftist, Marxist. My mom was a Sanskrit drama professor. They could hardly agree on anything, so therefore it gave me the room to form my own opinions. But they had great values, and that helped.
What's the best professional advice you've ever been given?
Believe in yourself more so than you think you do. I am Satya Nadella, CEO of Microsoft. All right.